locked in the game.
Someone put me out cause I'm on fire. I can't give a shit about what they say. They've been searching for that thing and get them higher. You can't catch my drift, can't catch my wave.
Poison the multitude, they be quick to accuse. When you got different views, just know you gon' pay the price. But stop by hiding, you choose.
I'm sizing your culture, I lead you with the chemical. I knew you was a vulture, I knew you was with the ushers. No, 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 I can't touch you. I'm shocked you got out your first time crashing, then I was cut. Shut up, I'm holding on through the road. If you were gonna be this junk at the top, I was gonna be something. The murder gotta stay hunting. Why the rush up for nothing? 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 Agitated illusion, only built for confusion. The institution, modern day execution. Think I knew the solution, maybe.
Sometimes you need a friend, not the ones that just show up and don't put nothing in. You know the ones that lend a hand and wanna see you win. When you come up on that lick, make sure you cut them in. And then, sometimes you need a foe, one to keep your eyes open, keep you on your toes. You know the ones that wanna keep you where you've been before. But I can't go, no I can't go. And whoa, sometimes I need a check.
You know, I sat down with my accountant. He said, I got good news and I got bad news.
Okay.
I said, what's the good news? He said, the good news is you made a lot.
Okay.
I said, what's the bad news? The bad news is you spent more.
Okay. Look, sometimes you need the faith. Sometimes you need to know your worth. Sometimes you need to wait. Shoot like the golden boy, but ain't from the bay. You can't negotiate with Drake. You gon' have to pay, but wait. Jugging on the main stage with the mainframe. Loosen up your face, baby. Sometimes I need a vacay, meditate, hydrate, protect my energy before engagement.
Grew up having nothing, you're labeled impatient. But once the boss made it, you're labeled amazing. Meticulous with words, such a force of nature.
Boss.
I don't wanna seem absurd, but that boy's a gangster. Focusing on me, way from Tel Aviv. Barbados with the hustle pockets, LIDs. Distinctive destinations, all I wanna see. Oceanfront residences, three different ones a week. Cause I deserve that, it's time to learn that. Mess around and put that thing up where you're permanent. Six figures every year, yeah, I earn that. At the front of this line is where my turn at.
Sometimes you need a friend, not the ones that just show up and don't put nothing in. You know the ones that lend a hand and wanna see you win. When you come up on that lick, make sure you cut them in. And then, sometimes you need a foe.
Oh. Men gon' lie, women gon' lie. You're looking for the truth and the numbers don't hide. Looking for the root of all evil, then you need to go open up the briefcase, see with your eyes. Everybody claim to be great at spa times, but they never spend a day in the rain in the front line.
No lie.
Stop playing on my phone line. Pull up in the space group with the roof optional. Wonder why they follow suit. I've been groomed from the womb. Came out of my mama with some running tennis shoes. Faster than the speed and bullet.
What you gon' do?
Game over, time's up. Play my cards, dumb, my hand ain't really no time for luck. Either you got it, you don't. Lie to yourself if you won't. I put my team on my back. Did what I could, what I had. Now I'll be all in my bag. Copy and paste with the swag. Bet you can't do it like me. All my winnings on repeat. Take your L like a boss. Stand 10 toes on your feet. I can never take a loss. I ain't set up for defeat. 4 Giottos on.
There's a look at one of the most iconic sports venues in the lower 48, built back in 1957 under the title of City Stadium. We are at Lambeau Field in Green Bay, Wisconsin. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence. fans a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it. This crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Detroit Lions and the Green Bay Packers. The first 2 months of the regular season down. What will the final two bring us as we're off in week nine? That'll be taken about a yard deep. And he'll wind up getting a couple extra yards here for his trouble, bringing it out of the end zone as he's down at the 27.
At their own 27-yard line.
For the first time with DeAndre Swift. And he'll push his way forward to about the 32. The game's first play produces 6 yards, brings up second down. If you start assessing what went wrong last week, Charles, and their loss, had nothing to do with the ground game. They ran it well.
And you also have to say to yourself as a team, don't go away from what worked. That's not the reason the game was lost. Running the football over time, when you do it consistently, usually translates into wins.
And they're hoping to do it consistently here. And he's got his man on the out route. And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
Lions.
Let's go. 56.
They'll set up to throw. Get this one to McFarland out of the backfield. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. 15 yards for the Lions there on a first down.
Detroit.
Now it's Swift. And he got blown up. Losing yardage on the play back at the 44. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
Nice play right there to stop him behind the line, but I want to see how this defense continues to play him here in the first half.
Yeah, we know. You know better than I. He has the ability to take over a game, so what do you do?
Yeah, I think you have to make sure that you bottle him in at varying levels, because if you crowd everyone to the line of scrimmage, if he breaks through, it's nothing but room to run.
That's to his running back, Kerryon Johnson.
The pass.
Give him 6 on the play, and that's going to lead to a third down.
Oh, I came to my feet on that one. I thought he was getting close to breaking that one big, but in the end, give some credit to the defense, finding a way to get to him and forcing a third down.
On third down, here comes Swift. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. They get the first. The decision to run on third and medium winds up being a good one.
And the Lions first down.
He'll look to throw. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 17. And he's going to get this one to the 23-yard line. It's no secret he's had trouble this year with interceptions, and this is a bad start for him. First drive, throwing another pick.
No matter who's broadcasting his game, that's how the conversation begins. Throwing too many interceptions. Can he take care of the football? If I were his backup, I'd be edging towards the coaches and saying, hey, how about giving me an opportunity?
Jones with a nice burst there on first down as he'll be taken down, but not before a gain of 7 yards.
A nice run here early on. It doesn't take a great play caller to realize you want to establish a guy his caliber who runs like this early, because they'll pay dividends as the game progresses.
Now a second down throw from Love here. And that's going to be incomplete.
A lot of times it's that first read that you have. Maybe you get it in pre-snap and he locked in on his target. But he was covered quite well, and that one's incomplete.
So the incomplete pass on the last play, and that leads us to a third and three. Here's Love. Over the middle, it's Thomas. And now look at this. Big gain, but a fumble. And this is scooped up by the Lions. And the return stops just a few yards shy of midfield.
Oh, that's bullshit, man. I'm down, bro.
They'll spot the ball at the 47-yard line. Detroit. So we've got a challenge. Our referee's going to take another look on the tablet. He's going to be watching to see if the knee was down prior to the ball coming out.
I love what you just said there. You nailed it, because if the ball's shifting or moving before the knee or any other part of the body hits the ground, then that'll be considered a fumble.
Now a first down carry by Jones. And he's going to get stopped up quickly. Give him a yard down to the 43.
No doubt about it. A really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there of holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
On second down, it's Jones. And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30. 12 yards there and a first down.
Well, there's plenty of real estate for him to maneuver on that run, and let's face it, it shouldn't be a surprise. He's one of the better backs in the league. Had to come into this game with the idea, slow him down, otherwise it's going to be a long afternoon.
Here's a throw out wide complete to his running back right side. A nice little screen. They get six on first down.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass. Looked like it was coming together. Looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid game.
We're scoreless after one.
First quarter with no score.
Back for the second quarter in Green Bay. It's the Packers in possession of the football. 6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and four. And they'll come up looking to keep this drive moving. Second down, Love. And this a quick slant to Lockett. And he will get this into the end zone. Touchdown, Green Bay. Tyler Lockett. His fourth touchdown on the year, as his guys are first onto the scoreboard here this afternoon. And it's good to make it 7-0 Packers.
Makes the score, Packers 7, Lions nothing.
This one away, and off it goes. Takes this about 5 yards deep. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback.
First and 10 at their own 19-yard line.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. They had the interception last time. It led to the opening touchdown. So now 7-0 to score as they start first and 10. And he'll be taken down at the 20 after a gain of just one. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9.
Second and 9.
They'll drop the throw. That's complete. It's Anthony McFarland. And they'll get 8 out of this before being stopped at the 28. And at his size, he's a smaller back. You can get him the football. He can kind of get lost, make someone miss. It's good for him.
Yeah, it's great for him. I like what you said there. Sometimes he gets lost in the traffic a little bit. But get him out in the open field into some space. That plays to his strengths the best and keeps him out of it where all the big boys are. You know, make him make someone miss in the open field.
Now a play fake here on first down. He'll buy some time right. Over the middle, he's got Watkins. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. Another first down as they call his number again. He's got 15 yards here. They'll run here with Swift. And he's going to get this one down to the 45.
Swift, the ball carrier.
5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five.
It's a gain of five. Brings up second and five.
He'll drop to throw. He'll find Swift out of the backfield. And this is going to result in another first down as the tackle's made at the Packers 35. They picked up 5 yards last time. Now they double it and get 10 here.
First down, Detroit.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Running is Swift. He's got a first down and much more inside the 20. Touchdown, Detroit! DeAndre Swift, his fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Lions are an extra point away from tying this thing up.
Well, partner, that was another explosive run, and one thing I've learned in our time in this game, yes, the offensive line has to get a lot of credit, but for big runs to occur, the wide receivers have to block well downfield.
And then you have to have a good guy carrying the ball too, right?
Oh, without a doubt. You need that difference maker lugging the rock.
So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And this return will net positive as he gets past the 25 and up to the 27-yard line. About set to get this drive started, the Green Bay offense at the line. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Second and 10 now from the 27. Love going to give this one to Jones. He finds an opening past the 40. He gets it across the 50 and down to the 48. That one good for 26 and a first down. Yeah, I have a pretty good friend, Charles Davis, who tells me that when he sees plays like that, strong runs to the right, reminds him of the 1960s Green Bay Packers.
Boy, those were the days back when the fullback actually carried the ball as well as blocked. Then you had a halfback. He had pulling guards, guys who could get out and run. And you can hear the great coach saying it back then. So we get a seal here and a seal here, and we run this play right in the alley. It's another zone defense. It looks like it's open for possibilities, but they did a nice job patrolling the middle of the field and forcing an incompletion.
There's a throw over the middle. It's taken in by his tight end. And it's going to be another first down as they'll get him to the ground at the Lions' 24-yard line. 23 yards to pick up there. We've hit the two-minute mark of the first half. All knotted up. It's 7. Coming up at halftime, I'll go from one personality, that's you, Charles Davis, to another one in Orlando, the coach. He'll have stats and scores from around the NFL. You and Jonathan Coachman, both larger than life.
No doubt about it.
But you're stuck with me in this booth,
yes,
and he's miles away and smiling.
And happy.
And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the 5 all the way to the 3. 2 chunk plays in a row. The last one was over 20 yards, and so is this one.
First and goal at the 3-yard line.
2 big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. They'll try and run it in with Jones. And he will get this into the end zone. Touchdown, Green Bay. Aaron Jones with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Packers have taken the lead. Oh, I was just about to say he had missed an extra point all season, but there it is, his first miss, no good. he's back out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss. Fielded near the back of the end zone. And this will be a touchback as Grant opts not to return it.
At their own 25-yard line.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And looking at this situation, Charles, you got more than a minute. You've got all three timeouts. Probably no need to play this safe.
So what you're saying is that we're doing a little bit of a mind meld here, aren't we? Because I'm thinking along the same lines as you. This amount of time, don't be compelled to play it too safe. This is a chance to get points on the board. Press it a little bit.
Yeah, especially since a touchdown here gets you the lead.
Brings up second.
They'll operate from the 32-yard line here, second and three. Here's Swift. And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. A gain of 13, it's a first down. Well, he's broken off some big-time runs here in this first half.
Yeah, and let's just face it. When you go into a game, you think you've got the plays that are going to work. But when you actually get out there and they're starting to happen, your confidence rises. And he's running with terrific ability right now.
No gain on the play there. Second down.
Second and 10 at the 45-yard line.
Oh, he's able to outmuscle him here as he pulls it in. The Lions now going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. They'll look to throw here on first down. They'll roll him out right. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Darnell Savage. And he will have a first down as they're into field goal range now at the 30. When he went on the move there and started rolling out, I thought there was a window, but that window closed quickly, intercepted.
And sometimes, despite how big your arm talent is, you don't get enough on a throw when you're on the move as opposed to setting your feet and stepping into one. That may have been the case there, and the defense certainly benefited.
And the Lions pressure too strong. Down he goes. That's Deron Payne with a sack that time. Coming up now on a second and 15 following that sack. Final play of the half. Love escaping the pressure right. Looking long for Thomas. And that going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down. So we have reached halftime in what's a six-point game at the break. As we'll send you down to Orlando, we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, so it's the Packers set to receive the kick. They've got the lead as well as we are underway in the third quarter. Taken at the 15, a short kick. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30.
At their own 32-yard line.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. We have not seen much on offense from either side. These last few drives, it has been a struggle, hasn't it?
Totally, and you're thinking to yourself right now, if you're on offense trying to get things figured out, okay, we self-scout every week on our game plan. How many things do we do at certain times? What are our tendencies? Time to go to some of those tendency breakers and try and create some offense.
They always have those in their back pocket, don't they?
You have to, and if you don't keep abreast of what you're doing, you lock into a rhythm and make it easy for the opposition.
Looking for tendency breakers right now. Love now on second down. Whipping one into Allen. That's complete. And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line. They get seven out of that, so they're left with a third and three. A second down completion got him seven. Now here's third and three. Heavy on the edges. 53 is the mark. 53. There's a quick throw out left. It's complete. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 37-yard line.
A loss of two.
It'll wind up being a loss of two. And that'll bring up fourth down. On is the punter, Scott, here as he gets this one away. We'll call it a 42-yard punt, three on the return. And the Lions will take over.
At their own 21-yard line.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And in enemy territory last time through the interception. We'll see what they do on this drive.
Can't wait to see how it alters what they decide to do in play calling. Do they continue to throw the ball? Do they want to lean more on the running game? It'll be an interesting sequence of plays that they've got coming up.
Does it often affect the play calling with the interception? How much does that change what you do?
I think it does, depending on why the interception was thrown. Sometimes it's just a matter of the defense made a great play, so you continue to come back. But if it's on you, if the offense just doesn't have the confidence, if they're a little bit shaky, maybe try and take the pressure off and run the ball a little bit.
16 yards, a first down.
Lions.
Now back to throw. That's into the hands of his running back, McFarland. And they get to him after a gain of six to the 46. Looked like a pretty good safe play right there. No, he's had trouble with the interceptions in this game there. Hits his guy out in the flat.
Yeah, so many times we hear quarterbacks and offensive coordinators talk about in your progressions, you're either throwing the touchdown or you're throwing the check down. But earlier in the game, it was touchdown or interception. Now he got to the check down, a nice safe throw and a good one.
It's a first down on a gain of 10.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
On first and 10, it's Swift. And not able to break away this time as they're going to stop him right around the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
Second and 12 at the Packers' 46-yard line.
Here we go on second and 12. Flush to his right. And he's going to keep it here. And that'll be incomplete. We do have a penalty flag down, however. Let's see what that's about. So he was past the line of scrimmage when he threw it.
And as they say, that's a no-no. Got to be able to understand where you are on the field and not cross the line before throwing the ball downfield.
Maybe worse than the loss of yardage, they also lose the down. So now it's third and long. Looking to throw. He's going to sling this deep downfield. And unable to connect. Incomplete. Give them credit. They took their shot, but it's going to bring up fourth down. He's had trouble finding open receivers all game, CD, and that's because really there hasn't been many. This defense has been all over them.
Yeah, they're one of the better defenses in the league, and every time I talk to someone around the NFL, they all say the exact same thing. They're so fundamentally sound, it's hard to execute against them.
They'll score that a 36-yard punt, and the Packer drive will start from deep in their own territory with a first and 10. About set to get this drive started. The Green Bay offense at the line. We have not seen much on offense here from either side these last few drives. We've hit a wall, so to speak.
And have hit it hard, haven't we? Because the defenses right now, they seem to be a step ahead, don't they? Beating them to the point of attack, beating them to the punch. These offensive guys, they're tinkering like crazy. What's it going to take to get back on track?
Yeah, both sides searching for adjustments.
At the 12-yard line.
Third quarter of a tight football game as we come up on a second and 10. Throwing. Love. Gets this to his running back, Aaron Jones. And they'll bring him down here right around the 17-yard line.
Aaron Jones.
5 yards on the pickup, and that'll make it third down.
That might feel like a little bit of a lost opportunity there for the offense because the defense brought pressure that time. And sometimes against that, you can get out to your running back, and it could turn into a big gain downfield. What a nice job they did getting to him quickly and holding him to a short game.
And he's got Lockett. And he is going to have a Packers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Great way to convert on third down there. 21 yards the play.
39-yard line.
On first down, it's Jones. And this time they were ready for him as they'll stop him right at the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
Well, that was not what you would call straight line pursuit for a middle linebacker to make this play. He's got to work his way through the clutter to get to the ball carrier on the outside, and he does exactly that. That's called avoiding the trash.
He'll drop this underneath for Jones. And he'll go down, and that will do it for the third quarter of action. Back now at Lambeau. It's Packer football here as they've got the lead as well to begin the fourth quarter. Now he sets up the screen to Jones, and he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. Umpire threw the flag, usually always indicates holding, and that's what we've got.
And you know, depending on their positioning, where you are on the field, the umpires get different responsibilities, but always, always making sure no one's holding.
Third and long for Love. And that will be incomplete. Critical play in this football game, because if they pick up the first there, that clock keeps rolling.
Has to be a little frustrating for them, because they know that if they pick up a first down there and continue to eat away at the clock, really increases their chances of closing this one out. Now they're likely going to have to give the football up and sweat it out on the sideline.
Jakeem Grant on the return. The Lions take over first and 10. At their own 26-yard line.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. Their defense accomplished step one of the mission. They forced the punt. Now they'll look to erase that deficit and take a fourth quarter lead. Here's a good way to kick off a drive, complete over the middle. And they work this well upfield across the 45. Great way to start the drive. 20 big ones and a first down. Now a carry for Swift. And this will be taken across midfield and into Green Bay territory. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and 4.
Now, Brandon, that's the way you want to run the football. There should almost be quote bubbles above the offense right now. Bam, boom, biff. That's how they feel good about moving the football.
Once again, it's Swift. And he's got this pretty close to a first down as the tackle is made at the Packers 42. It'll go as a gain of 6 that time, and it moves the chains as well.
Detroit.
Back to throw now on first down. That's to his running back, Kerryon Johnson.
The pass.
3 yards the gain there, second down. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball, because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. They're tackling them almost on the spot. That means you have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
On the handoff, this is Swift. And some room to work. Touchdown, Detroit! DeAndre Swift with his second TD of the game, his sixth on the year. And now if they convert the extra point, the Lions will have the lead. And this puts him on top by a penny. It's 14-13.
Lions 14, Packers 13.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Thomas. And with a marker down, he's up just past the 25-yard line, but I think they're going to be going backwards. Let's check the call. Yeah, this is going to put him back with a not great field position.
So they really got zero benefit at all, right? Sometimes you can absorb a penalty when you get a big return, then the penalty brings it back, but you still have great field position. As you pointed out, not in this case.
We saw a number of good games earlier today. This one might top all of those. It's been a dandy as we come up on first and 10. Now he's going to swing this one out to his running back. Oh, he's got some breathing room. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. A good pickup there, 26 yards.
And here we are in the fourth quarter, partner, and we watch him drive for what would be a go-ahead touchdown. And you and I both know this is where you need a quarterback who can keep his cool back there, not just for himself, but to keep the rest of the team relaxed too.
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Here's Love. Caught on the right side by Jones. Give him 9 on the play, and it'll be second and about a yard.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
Second down, Love. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, third down.
It's been clear in this matchup which side has been the more physical one. It's been this defense. And here's another example on that last play.
Here we go, third and one. Gut check time on both sides. They'll try and run for it with Jones. And he will have a first down here at about the 40. A strong 8 yards will keep this drive rolling. And they gave themselves options there on the third down play and were able to convert on that RPO.
Shows a lot of trust with the guy taking the snap, doesn't it? Because you're counting on him to make the right reads and give the ball where it's supposed to go. And he did on that play.
And they'll keep on the ground with Jones. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. Second and 14. 44-yard line. Now Love. And he's going to drop this off to his fullback. Fourth quarter, 2 minutes on the clock in a tight one-point game. So it's Packer football here as we welcome you back. They face a critical third down now, needing a score here in the late going. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
They really had a good drive going there, but a nice recovery by the defense these past few downs, able to knock that one away on third down and bring up what I think for the offense, an unexpected fourth down here.
One score down, here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. Now Love. Out to the right, he gets it to Lockett. And he's going to get this inside the 30. They keep the game alive, at least for the moment, as it's a first down. He'll look to throw. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. Love looking to throw. He's going to find his running back. It's complete. It'll be a pickup of 15 as that'll lead to third down. Nothing open downfield. They went underneath.
Yeah, see if you can get it to your running back. See if you can make someone miss in the open field.
The Packers going to use one of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds left to go in the game. They had the catch on second down, but it didn't help at all. And now they're looking at third down here. Off the play fake, Love. And that is incomplete.
We've seen that the deep ball has been a part of their game plan all afternoon, but they've had trouble hooking up on it, unable to successfully find the end zone over the top.
So the field goal unit is on the field as this is a big spot right here. This to take the lead here in the final minute. And his kick is no good. Oh, by the slimmest of margins, he missed it wide to the left.
Everything looked good. Good snap, good hold. Sometimes, though, the ball just doesn't want to go where you want it. And this one winds up no good.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And checking the timeouts, they do have two defensively, but no real need to use them as they're not going to be able to stop the clock after that. On the ground is Swift to start the drive. And he'll be tackled just past the 35 at the 36. Now the Packers going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as it'll come with 36 seconds to go in half number two. The first down run got five. Here's second and five. They'll stay on the ground with Swift. A gain of five, good enough for the first down.
It carries like that. That's how they're going to continue to salt this thing away here, Charles, in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, how about that? A new set of downs. Clock continues to move. No better way to close out a game than to tap those mastodons you have up front and say, guys, keep pounding them. Let's keep the ball, keep their offense on the sidelines, and let's close this one out.
So still 14 yards to go, second down. Here's a handoff to Swift. They'll get a couple yards back, but not more than that. They'll be left with 12 yards to go on third down. So this one's over. It's a win for the Detroit Lions. And it was their defense that really made the statement after the break. They pitched the second half shutout.
Yeah, think about the team that just got vanquished. They did score in the second quarter. Do you think they thought at all that that would be their last points of the game?
No, but what a second half. The adjustment, whatever they did in the locker room, it certainly worked.
It certainly did, and you're exactly right. Whether it was an adjustment, whether it was just more focus on what they planned to do going in, whether they just played better, whatever it was, it all came together in the second half, and no points were allowed. That's a great way to close them out.
So for Detroit, it's a nice win to finish off what's been an ugly first half as they move to 2-6. And they will head home next week to take on the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Meanwhile, for the Packers, they'll fall to 5-3 with a loss. And they'll be on the road next week for a matchup with the Carolina Panthers. Thanks for tuning in, everybody. Alongside Charles Davis, we thank our entire crew. I'm Brandon Gauden. This is the NFL on EA Sports.